I'm John Marion.
And I'm Barbara Ann Marion.
And we are here in Yugoslavia, a very, very beautiful country. Why Yugoslavia? Because the Madonna, the Blessed Mother, has called us to be here. And she has asked that we bring this message back to you wherever you are.
People come from all over the world to this little spot nestled between two mountains called Medjugorje. They come with heavy hearts. They come with broken spirits. They come seeking questions. They come seeking miracles in their life. But the true miracle is the miracle of Mary's love and Mary's touch when their hearts are transformed. We hope that as you watch this presentation, that you too will find that your heart is being transformed.
When I first came to Medjugorje, I guess I was just sort of like caught up like all these other people, you know, wanting to see the sun, wanting my rosaries to turn, wanting to go up the mountain, wanting to see the visionaries. And, you know, it's the first time I was here, I just thought, well, what am I doing in the middle of nowhere?
I came to Medjugorje to pray for a healing for my daughter Kirsten, who was struck by a drunk driver. And she suffered very severe injuries, and we've seen some miracles already. Ultimately, we're here because she's paralyzed from the waist down, and we've come to ask for her healing.
I'm a scientist, and I've seen certain signs that science cannot explain to me. And I have no doubt that she is a better man.
Well, I came just because I think here is the best place to be. Very close to heaven. You connect easily with God through the gospel.
The place, St. James Parish. The location, Medjugorje. A tiny hamlet of 400 families located in the communist bloc country of Yugoslavia. Why have over 15 million people from around the world flocked to this tiny village nestled between the mountains? Reportedly, six young people, four girls and two boys, experienced daily apparitions of the Madonna. The apparitions allegedly began on June 24, 1981, on a hill named Pobrodo, better known as the Mount of Apparitions. In 1982, the apparitions moved from the mountains into the church compound, bringing about a fusion of the apparitions and the messages into the everyday life of the parish. The apparitions were integrated with the recitation of the rosary, the sacrament of reconciliation, the Eucharist, and a healing service. When the apparitions first began, they often lasted as long as 40 minutes. Today, the visions have been lasting only 1 to 3 minutes. During this time, Our Lady, Queen of Peace, is seen by the visionaries as a three-dimensional figure, someone they can see, hear, and touch. She is always preceded by a splendor of light described by the seers as glowing with holiness. When the Madonna speaks, she speaks softly and in their native Croatian tongue. Before an apparition, the visionaries prepare for the Madonna with prayer. When she appears, she prays along with them. As they are conversing with her, you can't hear their words, although you can see their lips moving. It is during this time that the visionaries lose all sense of time and space as their eyes remain fixated on the beautiful Queen of Peace standing before them on a cloud. You are now witnessing an actual apparition between Yakov Cholo and Ivan Dragicevich in the choir loft in St. James Church.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God.
Dear children, today I want to call you to pray, pray, pray. In prayer, you will come to know the greatest joy and the way out of every situation that has no way out. Thank you for moving ahead in prayer. Every individual is dear to my heart, and I thank all of you who have rekindled prayer in your families. Thank you for your response to my call.
Why did the Madonna choose Medjugorje? Why is St. James Parish such a focal point for this time in history? Father Philip Pavich, an American-born Franciscan, along with noted theologian Father Tomislav Pervon, pastor of St. James Parish, comment on why the Madonna chose Medjugorje.
Momentous things have happened here. We all believe that the Mother of Jesus, our own Holy and Blessed Mother, has been appearing here since June 24, 1981. Before the apparitions, it was a traditional parish of this area of Herzegovina. It was a devout parish. The people had old faith, devotion. They've been Catholic here for 1,300 years, the Croatian people. So there's a long tradition of devotion and also love of the Blessed Virgin Mary. So there was here a true traditional faith, and it was something that they very much adhered to consciously. So I would compare the apparitions here to something like the Holy Spirit descent at Pentecost in Jerusalem. So from that moment, just as the apostles became witnesses to Jesus' risen reality, so too from the moment of the apparitions, the faith of this people kind of clunked into place, and they stood up as witnesses of the reality of their faith and their long-standing love for Jesus and Mary. The traditional greeting of the people here is to greet one another with that greeting, "Praise be Jesus and Mary." The response is forever and ever. And the same effect takes place for the priests and the people who come here. We find a strengthening of their faith so that they are willing to go out and be witnesses for what they have experienced also. And so just as the church became a witnessing church after the resurrection, so too after the apparitions, the parish of Medjugorje and the pilgrims here become a witnessing church.
From around the world, pilgrims are being called to St. James Parish, an oasis of peace and love, healing and transformation, to become an integral part of a witnessing church.
Janie had was diagnosed with leukemia 3.5 years ago and had a bone marrow transplant in January. And we went for his three-month checkup to see how his blood was doing. The doctor had said that they didn't like what they saw, that he would be fully relapsed within a month, and he needed a miracle to be cured. We definitely feel we were sent here, and we've been praying for a miracle. And we also have offered Danny into Christ's hands, and that we are praying that his will be done. And we know that whatever happens, it'll be God's will.
My name is Elisa Santoro, and I'm a surgical oncologist in St. Barnabas Hospital in Livingston, New Jersey. I was very touched by their story. They brought a boy here, 7 years of age, long journey for anyone who's not sick and not burdened with a sick child. And their hope was very touching. And it was a good hope. It was very solid. It was whatever God's will is. Of course, we all have our desires for healing, and their doctors told him that he needs a miracle to be cured. I'm interested in the healing mission of the church, since I am a surgeon and an oncologist, that malignancies, of course, touch me very much, especially that when one sees a child, we are all focused on that child. The child is such a symbol of hope And when a child is facing death, everyone feels it almost more. It seems against nature that a child should die before one's parents. Miracles still happen today. Absolutely.
The Madonna is asking all of us to open our hearts to her son unconditionally. She has no interest here on her own. She truly wants the good news to be revived and lived in our hearts. Her messages are not prophetic. They are simply invitations to healing and freedom through her son, Jesus. The major accomplishments of Medjugorje are its fruits, developing under difficult conditions with the visionaries maintaining simple lifestyles under stressful circumstances. They are, according to Father Rene Laurentin, leading lives of profound holiness, praying three or more hours a day, and fasting with their families. Are we willing to radiate and transmit the Madonna's messages to those we meet by our example? Vika Ivankovic challenges us to bring her messages into our hearts.
The Madonna would like us to live the messages as she gives them. Peace, prayer, fasting, and conversion. She says before prayer we should forget about everything else. Go down to your knees in front of the cross, and from day to day open your heart. Think about every word that you are pronouncing, and live it throughout the day. We are praying to the Blessed Mother and God to help us to open our hearts. We are sure that they're going to do this for us. It all depends on how much we really do desire this. The Blessed Mother says to pray three rosaries a day, not with just words, but from the heart. If you pray with just words, the prayer does not work.
Vishka, do you ever find it difficult to pray? How can we apply suffering to our everyday life to obtain graces?
If God has allowed us to suffer, we must accept it with love. He knows exactly why we are suffering and when He will take it back. He is looking for our patience. The person who is suffering is a great person in God's eyes. Don't ever allow yourself to say, "Why did you give me this cross to carry? Give it to somebody else." We should be willing to thank God for all of our suffering and be ready to accept more.
My dear children, in these days, many people of all nationalities will come to the parish. And now, I am calling you to love.
I have been here 17 times, and since the last, the first one, my life changed completely. So afterwards, I decided to bring as many people as possible. Most of the times, I'm here only with relatives. But few friends are also accompanying me, and I will keep this idea the rest of my days.
You've come here 17 times. How long ago did you start coming?
I came my first time in 1985, October.
That's 18 months.
That's right. Every month, almost. I should say that now this is my only duty in life, to bring people to have a close encounter with the Lord through Mary, that I love her very much. She was the one that made me love our Lord. I'm sure of it, because now I am in love with Jesus, and my life is a new life. That's the most important. And praise the Lord.
Dear children, I am calling you to more attentive prayer and more participation in the Mass. I want you to experience God within yourselves at Mass. Thank you for responding to my call.
When I first came to Medjugorje, I guess I was just sort of like caught up like all these other people, you know, wanting to see the sun, wanting my rosaries to turn, wanting to go up the mountains, wanting to see the visionaries. And, you know, it's the first time I was here, I just thought, well, what am I doing in the middle of nowhere? So It really didn't hit me, I don't guess, until after I got home. I was home for about 2 weeks, and it's like once you leave here, you kind of go through withdrawals. And I was home for about 2 weeks, and I needed something else. It's like, how can I get these feelings back from Medjugorje? And I discovered that by attending daily mass, it brought me closer to God. It was the first time that I really felt God was really present in my life, along with the Blessed Mother. I never thought about praying unless I needed something. But now I pray all the time. I not only pray for me, but I pray for other people. And I also pray that I learn how to pray, so it can come from my heart where it's supposed to be. And there's just something that keeps driving me back here. It's just the sense of peace. You don't need to come to Medjugorje to get the sense of peace. But once you're here and you have it, it just stays with you. And I think in order to renew that feeling of peace, you have to go to Mass. You have to allow yourself to be closer to God. And you have to believe that the Blessed Mother is here. You have to believe that she's here with you and is helping you to get closer to God.
The Madonna's messages are making a tremendous impact on the world. She is calling us to be visionaries to one another, sharing her message of peace. Father Svetozar Krajlevic comments on our role in becoming a visionary within our families and community.
For a long time we have been speaking about the apparitions of the Blessed Virgin Mary here in Medjugorje. And we see the atmosphere which radiates from her apparition to the people. It is peace, it is love, and that it is something that makes us all happy and comfortable. But all of us, every individual has a special time of apparition. We all appear to each other. And I just would like to ask myself and all the people to count on our own apparitions to our friends, to our neighbors, to our children, so that like the Blessed Virgin Mary, we might also radiate that beauty, that peace, that love that the Blessed Virgin Mary. It is a really very dramatic question that one could ask when I come in front of the eyes of my friend. When my friend sees me, what he feels, comfortable, do I radiate to him peace and joy and comfort and security? Is my presence of comfort and joy and peace to others? I think the very presence of the Blessed Virgin Mary is teaching us all how to make our presence to the people known and comfortable. And for sure the Blessed Virgin Mary is a perfect example to follow. Again, we all appear in the world and make difference with our own peace.
In addition to all the spiritual reconstruction and conversions taking place, signs and wonders are being reported universally.
Okay, my name's Kathy Springer, and I'm from El Paso, Texas, and what I saw yesterday I've never seen before. It was so beautiful. The sun was, I couldn't see the sun for many days, and then all of a sudden yesterday I'd given a scapular to somebody that didn't know about a scapular, and then all of a sudden people were talking about the sun, and I looked into the sun and I saw.
What are you talking about the sun?
Well, what happens is when you look at the sun, all the rays are coming down on you, you can't see it, but then I went like this, and then all of a sudden I could see it, and what it was doing, it was like circling around in circles, and then it was dancing, and then it would like pulsate, and then all of a sudden you could see, and it went to like a host figure, and then you could see the Virgin, or I saw her, and I could see like from here up, her profile of her, and that was obvious as can be, and then I saw the Holy Spirit. And then, you know, I knew my prayers were answered because I felt it in my heart. And the greatest miracle of Medjugorje is the conversion in your heart and the peace that you want to show everybody everywhere. And the love that you, I mean, all you want is to be with God, and you want to just love, and you want to care, and you just want to forgive anything that's happened. And you just the love in your heart and the true faith in God is really the true miracle of Medjugorje.
Luminary phenomenon continues, principally of two sorts. First, the cross of Mount Krzyżowiak disappears sometimes, replaced by a globe of light. And secondly, many also see the phenomenon of the sun, similar to the occurrences at Fatima with the sun dancing. You are now about to see dramatic footage of people witnessing the miracle of the sun.
Oh my God, come on. Yes. Yes. Oh, look at you. Look so beautiful. This
great,
beautiful
rain is
coming down.
I am looking above my head. It's like a moon.
Oh, can you see it? Oh, yellow, it's getting yellow.
I think I'm seeing it. It is spinning.
It's pulsating.
It is pulsating. Oh, it's nice.
Cameraman, get your own guy aboard.
But it's the shape of a host. It's the shape of the Eucharist. It's exactly what it looks like.
That's small. You can see it's like a little host. The sun is like a little host.
The host is white. The host is white. Totally, totally white. Behind it is like a bright light flashing on and off, but so rapidly it's almost constant. And all around it is a soft, soft rose color. And the clouds are framing it.
The whole sky is red. Rose all around.
Rose is brighter. I don't know how you... It's incredible.
It's turning one way and then it's turning the other way.
I see it more as a heart beating. I don't see it turning. And it's like I'm looking right through my hand.
It's spinning. Look at it.
Look, it's spinning. It is spinning.
It's spinning.
It is spinning.
It's
swirling.
It's
swirling.
But you can see it with eyes that glow. Yes, you can.
Yes. Oh my God. It's gold. Oh, it's like a car.
Look at it radiating down on you.
Yellow.
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 Yellow. Yellow.
All around.
May I use your sunglasses?
Yes, please. Thank you.
He is turning his face now.
Is this the first time you've seen it?
Oh, yeah.
First time you've seen it?
Look.
It's going in. Oh, my God. I can't just see that. Just coming.
It is breathtaking. It's turning his face now.
Is it pink?
Yes, it's fitting.
Oh, I turned it.
Oh,
no, you know, it's really bright right now. You need to wear some glasses.
Maybe
you just look straight into
a round circle. You can see the colors. You can see right into it. And then you can
see it's just a round circle.
Can you see the sign of the Holy Cross there?
I don't see the cross. Where's the cross?
Right in the center. I mean, it is all the sun is right in the center of the cross.
I don't see it.
You don't see it?
No, I
don't. Yellow.
But I know what I saw. Yellow.
You see yellow. I see pink. Pink around the sign.
It's yellow now.
Yellow. And it's crossing.
Oh, yes.
The pink rose. All rose.
That's only going to
turn it around.
At Fatima, the great miracle of the sun was witnessed by 70,000 people. But no astronomical observatory noted anything in its daily log about abnormal behavior of the sun. That was never empirically observed. And yet 100,000 people had mud dry up under their feet and had clothing dry. Now I think that tells us something about the sun. It will not be empirically verifiable. The great miracle of the sun was not verified by an astronomical observatory, yet it had physical effects in reality. All of Europe was under that rain-soaking weather front that made the muddy fields of the Battle of Flanders. That was the same thing that happened at Fatima. That was the same weather front. That's a historical fact. And when that all dried up, you have to say it had physical reality, had physical reality, but it could not be verified.
Along with the solar phenomenon, it has been reported that rosaries are turning to a golden color all over the world.
I have a bunch of rosaries, and this is the only one. Like, I have this one too, and nothing's happened to this one yet. It could happen.
The rosaries you had that turned gold are the same exact rosaries there?
Well, I don't know. My mom just gave them to me and brought them down.
They were silver as the ones that you're now clenching.
They're regular. Yeah, they were like this.
And they're now...
This one. See, this is my sister's, this is my brother's. But he's the one that needs a miracle, and it's going to happen.
And they turned that gold.
I promise you, you can look at it.
It's beautiful, I believe.
You know what? The rosary soul, you can see it, but what I saw yesterday... In the sun, when I saw the Virgin, I saw the Holy Spirit, and what I know in my heart and what I feel. God, the grace of God everywhere. I mean, the dear Lord was kind enough to let me see. And I said, I didn't think I was going to see, because I said, well, I accept it. But now, I saw, and I'm very grateful. I'm very grateful.
That's beautiful.
So, I thank God.
Well, this morning, I was just beginning my office. And I felt the need to just, I was laying in bed reading my office, and I felt the need to go to the window because the sun was coming up over the mountain, and to just pray the Psalms facing the sun. The warmth was beautiful and brilliant, and the miracle of the sun occurred again. The sun was beautifully spinning, and it was so open and present to me. And as I was praying the Psalms, the pages of the office were just gold. It was just, again, a confirmation, I think, of the inner movement that all of us have experienced this week. And that's how I read the sign, the miracle of the sun, and the gold pages or the gold links of the rosaries. It's God's physical way of saying to us, yes, you've all been open to my presence and to my power. And I'm just confirming that for all of you. It was just an extraordinary morning of prayer.
It's very important for us to remember that in paradise we were created with Adam and Eve to be visionaries. We were created to see God face to face. And we're in exile now. We're living in Siberia. Don't get too comfortable in exile. So that's part of the message here. Don't worry about how big a bankroll you got. Remember, you're still in exile, okay? So you're making it big in exile. Oh, yeah, you know, you're driving a Cadillac in exile. You're still in exile. This is not normal life.
We don't see God. We're a little bit afraid of him. We wonder where he's at. We're looking for him and so on. We're hoping we're... And we're trying to get confidence. The Holy Spirit witnesses in us, but we still don't see him. We're looking to see him face to face. In other words, we're destined to be visionaries, but we're not visionaries yet. Now, all these phenomena are much less than what God has already given us. See, he's given us his Son to make us visionaries. The greatest gift he's already given us. So rosaries turning to gold, fine. It's that, those are candy kisses. He's just throwing them out. Because he's given you his Son. He can't give you more than that. All these things are less than what he's already given us, but they're real.
I'm a scientist, professor of medicine at the University of the West Indies. But I have had certain special experiences here in Medjugorje and before, particularly here in Medjugorje. This is my third visit. And I've seen certain signs that science cannot explain to me. And I have no doubt that she is appearing here. I have no doubt that the physical signs that many people have seen are her manifestations in an effort to lead those who are doubt into faith.
You see, the mystery of Medjugorje is more than just a little Western Yugoslavia village. Our Lady has validated the name of Medjugorje as a mystical reality for the end of this millennium. It's a symbol of the church. Why five message words? Peace, faith, conversion, fasting, prayer. We've heard that before. But what makes 10 million people want to do this? The presence, her presence. That's the unique new reality. The only novelty, the only newness at Medjugorje is her presence, empowering this and calling this whole reality to our lives.
In this unique time in history, Medjugorje calls us to be increasingly aware of Mary's presence in the mystery of Christ. During this Marian Advent, she's preparing us for Jesus' 2000th birthday. Our Lady said yes for the human race. Each one of us must echo that yes for our own lives.
My brothers and my sisters, I have failed.
message lives on.
My dear children, go in the peace of God.
My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord, and my spirit exults in God my Savior, for he has looked with mercy on my loneliness.
Fiske, you are a very patient and beautiful young lady. I feel like I'm in the presence of a saint. We thank you very much for taking so much of your time.
Oh, I don't mind. I know you're not doing this for yourself. You're doing it for other people and for the glory of God.
May God continue to bless all of you who chose to make a difference by helping to spread Mary's message for the glory of God.